Aaron Beck is very big. Aaron Beck is a name that is worth knowing in the cognitive perspective of depression. And the idea here is that, and we talked about these things before, way back, we talked about structuralism, functionalism, psychodynamic perspectives, behavioral perspectives, humanistic perspectives, and cognitive perspectives. His perspective is that the way people who are depressed think predisposes them to becoming more depressed because they then focus on negativity to the exclusion of positivity or evidence of at least neutrality. So errors in interpreting self, errors in interpreting the world, and errors in interpreting the future become problematic, such that you have a triad. Internal. Life is bad because of me, because I'm worthless or not good enough or won't achieve success or am incapable, whatever. Negative thoughts about oneself, right? Coupled with, it's probably always going to be like that. So therefore, there's not a lot of hope for the future. And it's global. It's all areas of life. It's not just work where I'm having problems, but work, home life, you know, what I want to be as a person, kind of existential issues, as well as kind of daily life issues. It's kind of like everything is negative. And with that depressive triad, you would expect that people just aren't going to be very happy. If that's the way you think about the world and you get stuck in what Albert Ellis would call automatic negative thinking without putting it in check or testing it, it makes sense that you would be depressed. And that's another way of looking at depression, because there's a lot of ways to look at depression that's turned out. It's not just one thing. A lot of people go, that's a chemical imbalance, isn't it? But we'll see that that's not necessarily what it is. There's certainly chemicals involved, but there's chemicals involved in everything. There's nothing that you think, feel, or do that neurotransmitters aren't involved in. And if you're like me, not good at sports, you don't say, that's a chemical imbalance, isn't it? Right? You just have an imbalance in the things that make you able to do sports. No, and don't think about it that way. But there's neurotransmitters involved in everything, and there's some consistency. We see that correlations have been found between mood disturbances and the neurotransmitter serotonin, norepinephrine, acetylcholine. But correlation does not necessarily equal causation, right? It could be that your low levels of serotonin, for instance, cause your depression, possibly. That's the layperson's understanding of it, right? They say, it's a chemical imbalance. I don't have enough of a neurotransmitter, so I take an antidepressant to get more of it, all right? But it could be that your depression is causing low levels of serotonin. Or it could be that something else is affecting both, right? We don't have clear-cut experimental evidence. You can't randomly assign people to depression and see what happens. Right, making them depressed and seeing what happens. But we do know that there is some correlation here. But the thing is when you supply a neurotransmitter in greater amounts, it doesn't automatically raise mood. So giving somebody an antidepressant of a selective serotonin reuptake inhibitor type, where we are now inhibiting the reuptake of serotonin, thus more of it is in the synapse. Y'all remember that from the biology chapter? Yes, I hope. Right? There's more of it. If that was it, if there was just a chemical imbalance, well, now we have more almost instantly, pretty quickly after we take the drug, but we don't get mood improvement. We get mood improvement over a period of about 4 weeks, 2 to 6 weeks, depending on the individual, because you get that downgrade in postsynaptic receptors that goes along with it. And the process of those postsynaptic neurons changing their number of receptors, not upgrading it as you would think with more serotonin, but downgrading the number of receptors, takes 2 to 4 to 6 weeks to accomplish. And that's when you see the correlation in mood. So it doesn't seem to be the chemicals themselves so much as the biological processes involved are correlated with improvements in mood, but where they alone don't often work any better than psychotherapy. So psychotherapy has pretty much equal efficacy to medication. So we're not changing any neurotransmitters directly. We're asking people to change their experiences, and that might change their neurotransmitter levels. Y'all have a great weekend. Maybe we'll see you out tomorrow at the next door. I don't know.